Hi everybody, Caesar here. So welcome to another Real Drive VR tour. Today we are going to look at the Lamborghini Huracan, the successor to the Gallardo that ran for 10 years. So the Gallardo actually ran for 10 years and shipped more than 14,000 units back then until this successor took over. So Huracan, also known as LP610-4. Just look at this in, well, this bright orange color. Let's turn on the lights and take a look. Amazing, isn't it? Now, to be honest, I'm not exactly a fan of the Huracan. I personally still think that the Gallardo and the Aventador still looks way much better. In my opinion, Lamborghinis should be simply just jaw-dropping, and when you see one, it should give you the urge to have his poster up your wall. But unfortunately, I think the Hurricane doesn't quite appeal to me, but that's just me anyway. So let's see, 20-inch rims and carbon ceramic brakes comes as standard. Just to peep in into the driver's seat and we'll take a more intimate look later. So actually, I noticed that on this car, you can actually see quite a lot of hexagons. So, for example, the grille here, hexagons, and also on the rims, you can see that there's hexagons here, wing mirror, hexagon as well. Right, and where else? In the front grille. Yep, where the black color grills are. Still, we are looking at a very quick car, weighing in just around 1500 kilograms, 601 brake horsepower, and comes with a 7-speed sequential gearbox. Right, even the door handles, you can also see hexagons. And on the petrol cover, you'll spot that hexagon as well. Right. So let's see how it looks like on the inside. Right, so here we are at the Nürburgring Grand Prix circuit. Just want to go through with you guys the interior of the Huracan. So right in front of you, behind the steering wheel, you can see the main screen. So unlike the GTR that we walked through yesterday, the Huracan does not have a center screen, except for this small screen that shows the gauges. So the screen right in front is actually the main screen, where you have all the information and data that feeds into you directly, including the sat nav. So if you look at the side, so these are the knobs for the windows. and also the anti-frosting feature. Hiding the shadows right here would be the buttons for the lights, including the headlights and also the parking lights as well. So right here you see a series of buttons as well. So it's really for the windows, suspension, traction control, and of course the red color button will be the hazard lights. So here's the start button covered underneath that fighter jet looking cover. So you can actually start the engine in two ways. One is to leave the cover and access the start button. Otherwise you can just press through the hole. So I mentioned earlier that there's a lot of hexagons in the design of this car. So of course you can see hexagon right in front in the dash where the cluster gauge is. Then there's hexagon on the aircon vents, right, hexagon on the start button cover. They are basically everywhere, right? Even here as well, you can see, right? So the contoured seats are, well, at least it looks comfortable, and look at the stitching. This is the kind of details that Polyphony Digital has come up with. Such immaculate stitching here. Very detailed. So it's actually my second day using the VR headset, and I've sort of got used to it. Just to also share a bit, the motion sickness syndrome has sort of getting lesser, and drive slightly longer without feeling as nauseous as before. So I think it just takes some time to get used to this whole VR thing. Nonetheless, it's a very awesome experience, and I think you should really try VR if you have the chance. Right. So you can still see the Lamborghini emblem, the headrest, and looking the rear view, it's just a small window, just enough for someone to come through and see what's behind you. Okay, and of course the center screen here shows you the oil gauges and stuff. Have the Lamborghini logo in front of the passenger seat, just over there. Right. So, let's see. Now, this is what I meant yesterday when I talked about the GTR R35, whereby the pedal shifts move together with the steering wheel. So in this case you can clearly see that the Lamborghini doesn't, it is Huracan. So to engage first gear, there you go. But if you move your steering wheel and then you try to engage first gear, the animation doesn't show. Right. So it will only show when you are in the zone. So of course in the real Huracan, when you pull the two pedals together, it will go back to neutral mode. But of course this is not being rendered here. Right. So what I observe is, sitting here in the driver's seat, the distance between the windscreen and where I'm sitting is pretty far away. So yeah, it reminds me of going through a joyride in my friend's Lamborghinis. You have the exact same feeling as well. So one of the first things they notice is the distance between you and the windscreen, It's really far. There's so much space just right after the steering wheel and to the windscreen. Right, and also what I'm looking at here is the airbags cover. Of course, also in the hexagon. Okay, I think it's time to take this for a spin. Now, these buttons here that say Strada, Sport, and Corsa, it's for you to toggle your driving mode. So, three of them. Not sure what the default mode is for in GT Sport. I hope it's actually Strada. No, sorry, Corsa. Right, since we are driving this on the course. So let's see the engine. As high as 9,000 RPM. So let's go for a spin around the Nürburgring Grand Prix circuit. Let's see how this LP610-4 performs around here. Ready? Wow, the acceleration is just brutal. Necessary. another 2 minutes and 10 seconds. So my first impression of this car is definitely very quick. Yep. The acceleration is again simply brutal. So hopefully you guys enjoy the ride, and let me know if you would like to have any cars to be featured in VR mode, and I'll be glad to just feature the car for you. Right, so as usual, like and subscribe if you like this channel, and I'll see you guys soon next round. See you.